I'm Keyshawn Whitehead, and this is Manny's Highlight in Black History. It's Black History Month, a month that marks over 400 years since slavery was first introduced in the United States and 155 years since it was abolished. Today, we're going to take a look in our history and talk about a historically acclaimed Black leader during an era that most people wouldn't know of, and that's Mary Church Terrell. Mary Eliza Church Terrell was an African-American activist who fought for racial equality and women's suffrage during the late 19th and early 20th century. Graduating from Oberlin College, Terrell was part of the rising Black community and the upper class who used their position to fight racial discrimination. Mary was the daughter of former slaves. Born on September 23, 1863, in Memphis, Tennessee, her father, Robert Reed Church, was a businessman who became one of the South's first African-American millionaires. Her mother, Louisa Aries Church, owned a hair salon. She had one brother. Terrell's parents divorced during her childhood. Their share of wealth and beliefs in the importance of education is what gave Mary the drive and determination to attend Antioch College Laboratory School and later Oberlin College, where she earned both her bachelor's and her master's degree. Terrell spent 2 years teaching at Wilberforce College before moving to Washington, D.C. in 1887 to teach at M Street Colored High School. There, she met and in 1891 married Herberton Terrell, who was also a teacher. The Terrells had one daughter and later adopted a second daughter. Her activism started in 1892 when an old friend, Thomas Moss, was lynched in Memphis by white supremacists because his business competed with theirs. Terrell joined Ida B. Wells Barnett in anti-lynching campaigns, but Terrell's life work focused on the notion of racial uplift, the belief that Blacks would help end racial discrimination by advancing themselves and other members of the race through education, work, and community activism. It was a strategy based on equal opportunities to advance the race and her belief that as one succeeds, the whole race will be elevated. Her words, "Lifting as we climb," became the motto of National Association of Colored Women, the group she helped found in 1896. She was the NACW president from 1896 to 1901. As NAACW president, Terrell campaigned tirelessly among Black organizations and mainstream white organizations, writing and speaking intensively. She also actively campaigned for women's suffrage, which she saw as essential to elevating the status of Black women and the entire race. Terrell fought for women's suffrage and civil rights because she realized that she belonged to the only group in this country that has two such huge obstacles to surmount, both sex and race. In 1909, Terrell was among the founders and charter members of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People. Then, in 1910, she co-founded the College Alumni Club, which was later renamed the National Association of University Women. Following the passage of the 19th Amendment, Terrell focused on border civil rights. In 1940, she published her autobiography, A Colored Woman in a White World, outlining her experiences with discrimination. In 1948, Terrell became the first Black member of the American Association of University Women. After winning an anti-discrimination lawsuit in 1950, at age 86, she challenged segregation in public places by protesting the John R. Thompson restaurant in Washington, D.C. She was victorious when, in 1953, the Supreme Court ruled that segregated eating facilities were unconstitutional, a major breakthrough in the civil rights movement. Terrell died 4 years later in Highland Beach, Maryland. Thank you, Mary Terrell, for all the hard work you've done for the United States and the Black community. And that was Humanities Highlight in Black History.